Hello everyone and welcome to MediSimplified. So this is a recall video for INIS CET 2021 November session. And in this video, we are just going to discuss the question and answer. So and some relative points, which if possible, I'll discuss it here. The aim of this video is just to have an idea from which topic the questions are being asked in exams, so that anyone who is preparing for various exams, even if need PG or FMG, they get an idea from where the bunch of questions come, right? And we'll do a small analysis of the paper in the starting, and then we'll discuss the rest questions. So one more important thing, the AIIMS has not taken any non-disclosure agreement, so we can legally share all the videos, all the questions on any platform, even it is a YouTube, a Telegram, or anywhere else. So let's go further and discuss this INIS CET recall questions for this session. Right. So first, a small analysis. What different this time it was in the paper that in NEET PG 2021, there were no COVID questions. But in INIS CET November 21, we got approximately 3 to 4 questions regarding COVID. So I think NB doesn't want the COVID to be discussed anymore as a bad history, and INIS CET, the central institutes, want to stick on the topic of COVID, so that if any further responsiveness is required, people should know. They are just focusing that people should know about COVID, and also if it is a past, it is event, so eventually there will be questions from this topic. So INIS CET has taken 3 to 4 questions for COVID. The important subjects from where the bulk of question came were micro, patho, and pharma, right? From each subject, or if you combine them, around 70 questions were there. Yes, around 70 questions out of 200. They were integrated, right? Purely if you talk about micro, patho, pharma, there will be less than 50 questions. But the integrated knowledge, right? Whatever the faculties are now focusing on, the integrated sessions, the integrated lecture. This is just because the integrated questions are asked. Even if you don't know the topic from the major subjects like surgery, medicine, or gynae, if you have the knowledge of this small this major subject, that is micropathopharma, which is a second year prof subject, then you can score well in such exams. Rest, radio, around 7 to 10 questions were asked. NAT, image-based questions were asked. Ortho this time was something lengthy questions. You can say lengthy questions were asked from ortho. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 such options were given. Then 1 and 2 are correct. 2 and 3 are correct. Such options were there. So this was something about ortho. Mostly the question, the INIS CET was a lengthy paper, as I got from all my friends, and the questions were small. Questions were small, but the answers or the options given were lengthy. Now this is something to be thought of, that the questions were small as compared to the options given, and because they gave something like this: a question was given, a situation was given, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, arrange them, which of the following is correct, such or match the following. There were around 5 to 8 match the following, right? So no true or false, but match the followings were there. So you can tell it as a multiple correct option kind of questions, right? So this was a basic analysis. And pharma, new drugs, always asked. New drugs were asked. So this is a basic review of the INIS CET November 2021. And now let's discuss some of the questions. I think in this video, we'll discuss 50 questions. And first question, this was, which of the following is correct, right? So pleural thickening and unilateral lobar manifestation, this mostly people have not marked. People have marked either CORADS 0 is normal or CORADS 5, we see typical COVID manifestation. Now here we have a part of my video, which I have uploaded on YouTube, that is CORADS, right? The link will come up right now here. So in this, I have clearly mentioned that CORADS 0, it is not interpretable, means the scans are incomplete and we should repeat the scan. right? CORADS 1 is no or very low suspicion of COVID infection. Normal or infectious, non-infectious abnormalities is seen. Lung tumors, emphysema, sustained are seen, right? CORADS 2 is low suspicion. CORADS 3 is intermediate suspicion. CORADS 4 is high suspicion, right? And CORADS 5 is very high suspicion, and it is for typical COVID-19. And whereas CORADS 6 is RT-PCR positive, right? So if you go back to the question, pleural thickening, something was the option, I don't remember exactly, and unilateral lobar manifestation. So these were not the options, a correct option. Either CORADS 0 should be the answer or CORADS 5 should be the answer. And the correct answer here was CORADS 5 is typical COVID manifestation. What happens in CORADS 0? This is not correct. CORADS 0 means scans are incomplete, right? So you can get this table even on my Telegram, Instagram, and even you can find the video on YouTube. Now going further, the next question is again from COVID. I've taken all the three questions of COVID earlier and then I have discussed other questions. So most common ocular manifestation seen in COVID-19, pseudomembranous conjunctivitis, follicular conjunctivitis, retinal vein occlusion, and viral keratoconjunctivitis. So second question was most common ocular manifestation seen in COVID-19, pseudomembranous conjunctivitis, follicular conjunctivitis, retinal vein occlusion, and viral keratoconjunctivitis. So pseudomembranous conjunctivitis cannot be the answer as it is seen in due to bacteria mostly, right? Follicular conjunctivitis, retinal vein occlusion, and viral keratouveitis. The correct answer here was follicular conjunctivitis, which is the most common manifestation seen in COVID-19 patient in eye, right? So this was the answer. Now going further, the mechanism of the remdesivir was asked. MOA is mechanism of action, right? Mechanism of action was asked, and the correct answer here was inhibits RNA-dependent RNA polymerases, right? Remdesivir's mechanism of action was it is inhibiting RNA-dependent RNA polymerases. Now, this is a basic question, double bleb sign. You can study it in either OBS-GYNE or you can study in radio. And basically it was a question from anatomy. So it was again not integrated. It is a common topic which can be studied in multiple subjects. Such questions were asked, as I said earlier. So double bleb sign, these were the two options in which usually the students were confused. Remaining two options, even I don't even remember them, and it was not very much closer to this. So the correct answer for double bleb sign was amniotic sac and yolk sac. Now, this was something which I have seen many people discussing on the various groups. So patient came to you with a hand deformity of a nerve, which is the likely nerve damage. Options were median nerve, ulnar nerve, musculocutaneous, and radial nerve. So musculocutaneous option is cut. And radial is also gone. Here, this is claw hand. This is partial claw hand. This is partial claw hand, right? And this is seen by ulnar nerve, right? This is seen due to ulnar nerve. And this is the correct answer. In median nerve plus ulnar nerve is damaged when there is complete claw hand. Right. So correct answer for this one was this part is folded like this. So this was ulnar nerve palsy. If it is completely like this, then it is called as complete ulnar nerve palsy. And that is this is complete claw hand, and this is seen due to median plus ulnar nerve palsy. Now, this was something, not this full part, this part of the image was given, which I'm encircling it. And So this part of the image was given. Okay. And here was the arrow mark where I'm doing the star mark. Here was the arrow. And question was, which nerve passes from the mark structure? And here the answer should be fourth ulna, no, fourth cranial nerve, sorry. Now again, 14 days neonate, bilateral conjunctivitis, and X-ray shows infiltration, most common cause. Here the answer is directly chlamydia trachomatis. I have a video on YouTube called ophthalmology based image revision. Sorry. I have a video on YouTube with name of image based ophthalmology revision. In that, I have given this thing also, that chlamydia trachomatis and D2K will do neonatal and adult inclusion conjunctivitis. And this is the correct answer here, right? Streptococcus H influenza mycoplasma will not do a conjunctivitis in the neonate. The correct answer is chlamydia trachomatis. Chlamydia trachomatis. This is this. Sorry for the mistake. There will be many mistakes, I think. So chlamydia trachomatis is the answer. Going further, cyclosporine, again, mechanism of action was asked. So the correct answer here, the options were IL-2 transcription inhibitors. COX means there was cyclooxygenase written in the question, cyclooxygenase inhibitor, or calcineurin inhibitor. The correct answer here was calcineurin inhibitor. For drugs most effective to stop smoking. Now here the fourth option was not so relevant. This three options were given. Nicotine gums is not the answer. Now the two questions where mostly people had doubt whether it is varenicline or it is bupropion. Varenicline is most effective. Varenicline is most effective, but it is expensive. Right. So bupropion is most commonly used. But the question was most effective or most efficacious, something like that. Right. So if this is the question, the correct answer should be varenicline without any doubt. A bee sting, this is the questions here. I have very much simplified due to my name, very simplified. The questions are not so simple. There was something history and the child got a bee sting, then something happened. And the question was which antibody will be involved. And here the answer is IgE, type 1 hypersensitivity reaction, right? And the Ig involved was IgE. This was the correct answer. Now child, there was some history given. It was a lengthy question, 3 to 4 lines, right? Some history was given for 3 to 4 lines. Then, and the last line was on microscopy, starry sky appearance. Starry sky appearance was found. And which disease is associated with it? Means which of the following is disease? The disease in which the starry sky appearance is seen is associated with which of the following, right? So here, starry sky appearance, we came to the conclusion that it was Burkitt's lymphoma, and Burkitt's lymphoma is associated with MYC gene, right? So this was the correct answer here. Now fish is to be done in. The fourth option, if I remember, it was all of the above, if I'm not wrong, or it, I don't exactly remember, but the fourth option, I guess, was all of the above. It is no relevant. We don't do fish in all the HER2 positive. This was again not such a straight question. It was something regarding HER2 new was mentioned in 2 or 3 lines. Then it was said that when will you do fish? So these are the three major options in which we should discuss it. If HER2 new positive, so it is directly the disease is negative. If it's HER2 new 3 positive, it is directly positive. But HER2 new 2 positive is in between, right? It is indefinite or something like that. Means you are not inconclusive, something like this we can say. So in this, what we do fish. So the correct answer here was HER2 new 2 positive. Now, once again, characteristic of Langerhans-Cell histiocytosis. This was a straight one-liner kind of question. And here the correct answer is Burkitt granules. Now, if you see this, I have uploaded Basics of Dermatology in which I have explained about Langerhans cells. So in Langerhans cells, we see the Burkitt granules and the markers were S100, CD19 and CD200. And this helps in the diagnosis of Langerhans cells histiocytosis. And this in Langerhans cells histiocytosis, we see Burkitt granules. right? So this is the correct answer here. I'm going for the clear cell carcinoma of ovary. The question was according to WHO's classification, right? Clear cell carcinoma of ovary is classified into. Now this is the correct answer here is epithelial tumor. Splenomegaly is not seen in, it is direct answer is aplastic anemia. Now going further, there was a history, some big history, then it was written the child with, was present with chloroma. What should be the next investigation to confirm whether it is chloroma or not? The answer here is peripheral blood smear. Okay, peripheral blood smear. Now center of hand and eye coordination, whatever I am doing, right? Hand and eye coordination. I am looking here and doing this coordination. Where is the center located, right? So the answer here is parietal. If it is asked more further, inferior or superior parietal lobe, like you can expect it in further exams, right? Superior or inferior parietal. So it is inferior parietal lobe. The more appropriate answer will be inferior parietal lobe. Hand-eye coordination, inferior parietal lobe. So they, here the answer was parietal lobe. Now, Pacinian corpuscle for pressure. Least radiosensitive, it is S phase. There is a controversy here also. Some say that S phase is most radiosensitive. And M phase is least radiosensitive. Is most radio resistant, S phase, and M phase is most least radio sensitive, which was asked. Right, once again, the question was which phase is least radio sensitive. My answer, I marked the answer as S phase, but in some where I saw that it was written most radio resistant is S and least radio sensitive is M phase. So if I go according to that literature, the answer should be M phase. So this can be a controversial question, should be confirmed with some faculty, right? So whenever I confirm it, I will just let you guys know. Now, there was something written that FDA or WHO, someone, FDA or WHO, does the categorization of drugs into A, B, C, and X. And this is done for which thing? For safety, for dose adjustment, or for safety in pregnancy. So here the answer should be safety in pregnancy. Now, this kind of questions were many questions were there, such kind of, right? So first question was anti-epileptic drug, which can also be used for pain. And here in pain, I think it was neuropathic pain in bracket, right? Neuropathic pain. The options were A, gabapentin, B, lamotrigine, C, pregabalin, and D, carbamazepine. Now this is where the question ends. And now this were the four options from which you have to choose the correct one, right? Only option A is true, which means only gabapentin can be used, right? A, B, and C means gabapentin, lamotrigine, and pregabalin. Or ACD means gabapentin, pregabalin, and carbamazepine. Then all can be used. So here the correct answer according to me is ACD. That is gabapentin, pregabalin, and carbamazepine. Lamotrigine is not used for neuropathic pain. Now here, one simple question was there that obligate anaerobe is, the answer should be Pivotella. Some history, right? The question was very basic. Suppose, if it is asked, Paul Bunnell test works on which mechanism? So the answer, the question will not take a lot of your time. So, but there was something, the 2-3 line history, and then it was written Paul Bunnell test works on which mechanism, and here the answer is heterophile antibody test, which is another name for Paul Bunnell test, right? It is seen positive in infectious mononucleosis caused by Epstein-Barr virus, right? It is negative in infectious mononucleolysis like disease caused by cytomegalovirus. And this is how we do the DD, whether it is EBV or cytomegalovirus, right? If it is, the histories are same, right? The clinical features are same in Epstein-Barr virus causing infectious mononucleosis and cytomegalovirus causing infectious mononucleolysis like disease, right? So how do we do differentiate it? We do Paul-Bunnell test, right? Which is positive in Epstein-Barr virus causing infectious mononucleosis and negative in cytomegalovirus causing infectious mononucleosis like disease. I don't know when I'm saying like disease, I'm telling it wrong. So my next question, question number 24 was strawberry vagina with a discharge, drug of choice. Strawberry vagina, drug of choice is metronidazole. Now this was from Biochem, right? This question was from Biochem. It was written thymine deficiency leading to lactic acid production is due to which enzyme deficiency? Here the correct answer is pyruvate dehydrogenase. Right. The other options were pyruvate carboxylase, phosphoenol phosphatase, carboxylfinase. But the correct answer here was dehydrogenase, PED, pyruvate dehydrogenase, PDH. Right. Next was, which of the following is an amphiphatic lipid? The correct answer here is phospholipid. Now, drug given to a mother for fetal lung maturity in a preterm labor, right? If it is a preterm labor, we try to give the corticosteroid for fetal lung maturity, for surfactant development. And this is done using DEXA or beclomethasone, right? So DEXA, we give 6 mg, 4 doses in 24 hours. And beclomethasone, we give 12 mg, 2 doses, 24 hours apart, right? So here the correct answer should be DEXA 6 mg 4 doses. And another option which was there was DEXA 12 mg 24 hours apart. This is not the correct choice. Now, this is again a controversial question. Identify the life cycle. Some say that it was a repeat of hepatitis A. Some marked it as a coronavirus, seeing the structure of this virus, right? But I marked it as herpes, and this is why I marked it as herpes. This was the similar kind of image which I found it on internet, not from any regular author, but this VP16 protein was there, and this thing, alpha protein, beta protein and gamma protein. Now I did mark it as a herpes, and this is the herpes virus simplex virus replication cycle, which I got it on the internet. I have not found it in any book yet, but as much I remember the herpes classification, it is divided into alpha, beta and gamma group, in which herpes simplex virus 1, herpes simplex virus 2 and herpes human herpes virus HHV and herpes virus 3, right? And then alpha, beta and gamma, right? And in beta we have HSV 5, 6 and 7, and here HHV 4 and 8, human herpes virus 4 and 8. So this is the classification. I found it that after this it was divided into alpha, beta and gamma. I did some logic and I marked it as herpes. According to me, this is herpes. Still, let the faculty decide if they get this same image. This was the same image which was asked in exam. So I marked it as herpes, not corona, not hepatitis A. If it is hepatitis A, then it should be the repeat question, which was asked in 17 or 16 in AIIMS. But according to me, this was the same image, not similar. I'm saying the same image was given. And if the same image was given, the answer should be herpes. Now, the patient had McBurney incision. Now you want to convert it into Ruther-Morrison incision. Means a history was given of a patient. You are operating him. You gave a McBurney's point incision on the McBurney. Then now you want to convert this into a Ruther-Morrison incision. Which structure will you cut now? The options were external oblique, internal oblique, transverse abdominis, and rectus abdominis. This was not the, the further choice was A, B, C, D. And now in A, B, C, D, it was A, B, and C, C, B, and D. Only A, only B. These were the options. This out of this four, you have to choose some, right? So when we do a Ruther Morrison, we don't incise the rectus abdominis. We incise the external oblique, internal oblique, and transverse abdominis. So the correct answer should be A, ABC. That is external oblique muscle, internal oblique muscle, and transverse abdominis. Now, patient with hematuria, urine microscopy reveals transitional cell carcinoma, and on CT scan, we saw a 2x2 cm mass in the bladder. What should be the management? According to me, the answer should be radical cystectomy. Now, another question was, a nasogastric tube is best measured by, length of the nasogastric tube to be inserted inside is best measured by. Four options were given, very much something was like from nose to pubic tubercle, nose to abdomens, upper limb, umbilicus, something, various options were given. The correct option was nose to ear and xiphoid process. Right, what we do, one second, I'll show you something. Suppose for measuring the length of tube, we measure it from nose to the ear like this, and then from ear we tell the xiphoid process, right? And then this is the length of the wire which we will insert in the patient, nasogastric tube. I hope I am clear what we should do. Now, next question. As per WHO latest guidelines for management of labor, what is correct? For management of second stage of labor was asked, I guess. Second stage of labor, what is correct? Warm compress, no. All delivery should be done in lithotomy position. Again, wrong answer. One more option was given, and the correct answer was perineum support and deflection of the baby head to be done in the second stage of labor. Now, not this kind of image. This bag was kept separately and tube was there in the image. Like this was the image was. I got such a similar kind of image just. Now the patient underwent mastectomy and drain is put under the flap, right, using the following, and then the flap was closed. Which type? The flap was sutured or something like that, or packed, and which type of drain it is? It was a closed drain. Other options were open, semi-open, and semi-closed. The correct answer here was closed drain. Now, this question, you can say it is NEET PG 21 September recall or repeat question, right? In NEET PG, there was a question that you gave a bupivacaine to your patient, right? And he collapsed or some toxicity is developed. Now, what will you do? So option A, B, C, D was given. And in every option, it was CPR and CPR and CPR and CPR and. And with this, there was one option, that 20% intralipid infusion. CPR and corticosteroids was one option, if I remember it correctly. So bupivacaine is a local anesthetic. Its toxicity was developed in the patient, and four options were given, CPR and what will you do? The correct answer that time was 20% intraliquid infusion. Now in this INICT November 2021, the question was asked, 20% intralipid infusion is used for, and the correct answer there is local anesthetic systemic toxicity. That's it. Now, all of the following are reversible method of contraception except LNG Mirena. It is yes. Sterilization, no. Copper T, yes. OCP, yes. So LNG, copper T, and OCP are reversible, but sterilization, I think, is not reversible kind of contraception. So the correct answer, if the reversible method of contraception except was asked, the correct answer should be sterilization. Now, concentration of all of the following decreases in the PCT lumen except bicarbonate decreases, chloride, question mark, I was not knowing the answer, amino acid, yes, absorb, and glucose is 100% decreases, right? So, out by excluding them, I went to the answer to the chloride. Which of the following is a novel antidepressant drug? The answer here was vilazodone. This time, I got to know few new drug names due to the INICT examination. There were many new drugs asked in this examination. So I recommend that whoever is going for the next INICT or any next NEET PG, if someone is preparing, do prepare the new FDA approved drugs. Now, which of the following drug, you use a drug due to which the mortality is reduced. Mortality is reduced, but the disease is cured very late. Or disease is not cured. This was the question, right? Which of the following will occur? Incidence increases, incidence decreases, prevalence increases, and prevalence decreases. Suppose mortality is not reduced, means the patient is not dying, but he is carrying the disease. This is happening. The new disease is occurring. No, it is occurring. Okay. New disease is present, but the old disease is also there. So new disease plus old disease, we call it as prevalence, and it will increase. So the answer here should be prevalence increases. I hope my logic is clear in this question. Now, this was another question. Which of wave of the JVP is due to isovolumetric contraction? Now, this is a JVP, right? Now, the A is for atrial contraction. Then C is for bulging of tricuspid with ventricular contraction, right? X is downward movement of tricuspid with ventricular contraction, and V is passive atrial filling, and Y is atrial emptying. The correct answer here should be the option C, that is isovolumetric contraction occurs at, one second, the isovolumetric contraction occurs at C of JVP. Due to which of the following vitamin disorder deficiency, collagen formation can get affected? Now, there were one more option, I don't remember. So, scurvy occurs due to vitamin C deficiency. Rickets is due to vitamin D deficiency. Beriberi is due to some vitamin deficiency. Just remember that collagen formation is dependent on vitamin C, proline, lysine, right? So, vitamin C deficiency is causing scurvy, and in scurvy, if the vitamin C deficiency is occurring, collagen formation can get affected. Now, scurvy is being tested here, or you can see, say the collagen is tested here, but if scurvy is being tested, again, it was a kind of question which was asked in NEET PG, an image of scurvy was given, right? So the topics are being repeated in NB2 AIIMS, that is INICT exam. All of the following increases the gastric secretion except. So gastrin will increase gastric secretion, yes. Acetylcholine, parasympathetic, increases, yes. Serotonin, don't know. Histamine increases, yes. So histamine will, I think, stimulate GE cells or something, and then it will increase the gastric secretion. So the correct answer here should be serotonin. Inferior thyroid artery supplies all except, not all except was asked. This was again that kind of question where we gave, where we given four options, and out of four options, some options were correct. So these were the permutation and combination to be followed. So inferior thyroid artery supplies thyroid, parathyroid, thymus, or esophagus. 1, 2, 3 are correct, 2, 3, 4 are correct, 1, 2, 4 are correct, or all are correct, 1, 2, 3, 4. So does inferior thyroid artery supplies thyroid? Yes. Does it supplies parathyroid? Yes. Does it supplies thymus? No. Does it supplies to esophagus? Yes. So 1, 2, and 4 are correct, and the correct option here will be option C. Now identify the speculum. So this was the speculum which was asked in exam, INICT. Few students were confused whether it was Sims speculum or Costco's speculum, right? So the Costco's speculum. So here the correct answer is Costco's speculum, which was asked in examination. This is what Sims speculum looks like. right? So this can be asked in other further examination. Now arrange the following from lowest to highest order of stability, and this were the option given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this fixators we have to arrange from low to high in their order of stability. So it will be 1, more less than 2, less than 3, less than 4. So uniplanar with one rod is the lowest stability, uniplanar with two rod, then second. Diplanar is better than uniplanar, so 3, and Elizarov fixator is best. So 1, 2, 3, 4, in whichever option this was given, this was the correct answer. Now, which of the following visual field defect will be there? With the following visual field, where will be the lesion? Where will be the lesion? So this was the question. This is temporal side of vision is lost. So this is called as hemianomas. Sorry, this is called as bitemporal hemianopia. Bitemporal hemianopia. So for this, again, I told you in the beginning of this video that I have a video ophthalmology image based revision on YouTube where I have explained this thing very beautifully. And here, if you see that optic chiasma, which is 2, if there is any lesion, it causes bipolar hemianopia, right? Midline chiasmal lesion. So if you go back over this question, with the following visual field, where will be the lesion? Optic tract? No. Optic radiation? No. Optic chiasma? Yes. And occipital lobe? No. So see, if there will be a lesion in the optic nerve, it will cause blindness of the same eye, right? If there will be the pressure or damage in the optic tract, it will cause the opposite side of hemianopia, homonymous hemianopia of the opposite side. Suppose if the left optic tract is infected, so right-sided hemianomas, hemianopia. If the right is affected, left-sided hemianomas, hemianopia will occur. Now, once again, such question match the following weather, right? With match the correct options. So this is not just we have to match. Then we were given with A, B, C, D options with the correct matches. First, we'll match it here and we'll write the correct answer directly. Okay. So Adrid bird is, then this was for Japanese encephalitis. It was written in the question. So Adrid bird is the reservoir of Japanese encephalitis. Culex is the vector. Pig is the amplifier and human is the accidental host. So if we go by this, the 1 should be 2. B is 1. C is 3. And 4 is, D is 4. This should be the correct answer. And parentenic host was also given on the other side, which was not relevant to the question. Not relevant to the other options of the other side, right? So, Adrid bird is the reservoir for Japanese encephalitis. Culex is the vector. Pig is the amplifier. And human is the accidental host for Japanese encephalitis. Now, this was something very different. 4 eggs were given. These were the eggs. We have to identify the eggs, and the options were 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. The options were 1, 2, 3, 4. With various combinations. So if we go, we'll just write the correct answer here. This is 4 eggs, 4 sided eggs, right? 4 way. 1, 2, 3, 4. I don't remember the correct name of this exactly. So this is hookworm. This is hookworm. Then the second image was for Tinea solium. This was H. nana. And this is roundworm. So this was the correct answer. In whichever option you had this thing, that hookworm, comma Tinea, comma H. nana, comma roundworm was the correct answer. All the 4 options were with this 4 eggs only, which helped us to go to the correct answer. So this was given in the exam. Now, what should be the difference in the time if a patient is taking phenytoin and sucralfate? Now, this question, the correct answer should be 120 minutes. When you take the food or something, it takes 120 minutes to digest or absorb. in the stomach, and after that we give sucralfate. If we give sucralfate before, it will hinder its absorption. So the correct answer should be 120 minutes. The most efficacious drug in multiple sclerosis. Now here, one more option was given from S. I don't remember. So that was not the answer. Not the emeltizumab is the answer. Answer should be either natalizumab or ocrelizumab. Okay, natalizumab or ocrelizumab. Natalizumab is usually used in relapsing multiple sclerosis. But in question, I guess primary multiple sclerosis was asked. So if primary multiple sclerosis was written in the question, the correct answer should be ocrelizumab. If nothing was given, then the best answer is natalizumab. So according to the question, the answer should be there. Now, identify the following findings: in which disease it is seen and what is the causative organism. Right. Once again, in four options were given with different combinations. And this image was given. So this is alveoli appearance, or this is Reed-Sternberg cell. So it was alveoli appearance was not given anywhere. It is Reed-Sternberg cell. And after this was the finding. In which disease it is seen, the options were different, but the Hodgkin's lymphoma was there in the option. Hodgkin's lymphoma. And virus, or the causative organism for it, is Epstein-Barr virus. So in whichever option, this three was given in this order: Reed-Sternberg cells, Hodgkin lymphoma, and Epstein-Barr virus was the correct answer. So thanks for watching this video. Next video will come soon with the 51 to 100 questions, from question number 51 to 100. We discussed the pattern of this exam in this part. Discussed 50 questions. Got to know which are the topics from where the questions has been asked. What are the kind of questions now they are tending towards? And hope you found this video very useful. Do like, share, and subscribe this video with your friend, and subscribe to my channel MediSimplified. Follow my Telegram group and Instagram so that I can share this PPT of this whatever I have made, and you can receive it over there. Thank you.